How do you encrypt a group chat? The Double Ratchet algorithm provides end-to-end encryption for messaging services like Signal and WhatsApp, but only when two people are chatting back and forth. It efficiently updates the keys in such a way that an attacker would have very limited access. Even if they were able to read a single message, they couldn't read any previous messages, a property known confusingly as forward security, and they couldn't read too many future messages. They'd eventually be locked out again, a property known as post-compromise security. But it's only set up for two people. How do we get the same thing for group messages, the same security features? Instead of end-to-end encryption, we want end-to-end-to-end-to-end-to-end encryption, and that's a lot harder. I recommend that you watch the video on the Double Ratchet algorithm linked in the description before watching this one. It's not necessary, but it'll help. One option is to think of a group chat as a bunch of pairwise conversations. So each person uses something like the Double Ratchet algorithm to have a secure conversation with each other person. Group messages are really just a bunch of individual messages pasted together inside the app. We could visualize this structure using something called a complete graph. Every node is connected to every other node. It inherits many nice security properties from the Double Ratchet algorithm, but it's expensive. If you send one message, it has to be encrypted separately for every person. If you have a messaging system for your entire office, perhaps hundreds of people, the complete graph grows very, very fast. On the extreme other end, instead of having separate keys for each pair, we could have a single key for everyone. I'd visualize this option like a star. There's one key in the center and everyone is connected to it. All the messages are encrypted and decrypted with this key, which is easier, but it's not very secure at all. Some group messaging applications use sender keys, which are a kind of intermediary option, splitting the difference between security and scalability. But in all these options, it's expensive to add or remove group members. It requires sending around a lot of encrypted messages containing keys. So, what's a better arrangement? Messaging Layer Security, or MLS, is the first standardized multi-party key exchange, a protocol for communication among groups of people or devices. And it puts all the participants on a tree. Not the botanical kind, I mean this kind, with nodes connected by paths, which is usually drawn upside down from the plant. This is called the root, and these are called the leaves. Mathematicians use other terms that come from viewing it as a family tree. This node is the child of this parent node. The descendants of this node are all these, its children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and so on. This is a binary tree. Every node has at most two children. In fact, in this binary tree, every node has exactly two children. Trees like this have a very regular, simple structure. For example, the number of leaves is always a power of 2. 2, 4, 8, 16, and so on. We'll use these trees to structure a group chat. Each person, Alice, Bob, Carol, Doug, Edith, will be represented by a leaf. Unless the number of people in your group is a power of 2, some of the leaves may be blank. Nodes on the tree can have both a public and a private key, although some nodes are blank. The public keys are, well, public, known to everyone in the group. But the private keys are only known to the members of the group that are descendants of the node. So Alice knows these private keys, but not these. And Edith knows these private keys, but not these. It's important to note that in the MLS structure, the intermediate nodes don't really represent anything in particular. It's just a way for us to organize all of these keys to think about the information. Every member of the group keeps track of this structure locally, so they all need to be informed of any changes. Everyone in the group knows the private key at the top, or root node. So that key can be used to derive other keys. The root key is processed in layers, modified until finally producing the keys that the group members will actually use to encrypt and send messages. Within this layering, like a giant key factory, the keys are updated and modified. Remember the key derivation function that's used in the Double Ratchet algorithm? It's a function, kind of like a little machine, that takes in a key and spits out another key. But this function machine is very hard to reverse. If you know the output key, it's practically very challenging to go backward and find the input key. In this way, it's like a ratchet, a tool that you can turn in one direction, but not another. The key derivation function within the layers, the key schedule, updates the keys that are actually used to encrypt messages, cranking out new ones without the root key changing. The layers ratchet forward, deriving a new set of keys for every version of the group. In other words, each time the membership changes. An epoch, or epoch, the word with a controversial pronunciation referring to an era in time, is used in MLS to roughly mean a period of time with a fixed membership. So each time a person joins or leaves the group, we enter a new epoch. The important thing is that the keys change with each epoch. The people only have access to the keys from the epochs in which they were a part of. Say Alice wants to add Frank. First, Frank is assigned a new leaf on the tree. The tree might have to expand. Remember, the number of leaves is always a power of two, but that doesn't really change much. It just adds more blank nodes. Alice tells everyone to add Frank to their copy of the tree. Then he is sent a welcome message that gives him the current status of the tree, including all the public key information, encrypted so only he can read it. It's tempting to say, okay, let's just share all these private keys with Frank, the ones up the path to the root. But that would give him access to some of the group's previous messages. Instead, Alice needs to give Frank the key further down the layers. It was produced by modifying the root key, but Frank can't undo the layers, can't unratchet to discover the previous keys used to encrypt messages. So, a new person can be added without changing the root key. But sometimes it's necessary to change the root key. This could happen if, for example, Carol is worried for any reason that someone has access to her private key or another private key on the path up to the root. In this case, it's not sufficient to change the keys down the line, the ones used to encrypt the message. Carol needs to change the root key itself. First, Carol creates a new private key for herself. Next, she's going to use the key derivation function. Carol takes her new private key and applies the key derivation function to derive a new private key for the node above her. And then she applies the key derivation function to that key to get a new private key for the node above that, and so on, applying the ratcheting function from the leaf all the way up to the root. For this reason, the tree is called a ratchet tree. In the end, we have a new root key, one which can be used to derive new secure keys to send messages. But how does Carol share this new root key with everyone else in the group? First, she can share it encrypted with the key from this node. Since that private key is known to all of the node's descendants, everyone on the right side of the tree now knows the new root key. Next, Carol shares this new private key with this node, which Alice and Bob can access. Then Alice and Bob can each apply the key derivation function, the ratchet, to the private key at that node in order to obtain the root key. The key derivation function is a mathematical function. And remember, the definition of a function is that there can only be one output from a single input. So even though Alice and Bob and Carol are all separately applying the ratchet to get the root key from the key below it, they will all get the same results, always. Notice that Carol just had to securely send one new key, and Alice and Bob were both able to learn both of the new keys on their path up to the root. Carol still needs to share the new keys with Doug. She does this by directly telling him the private key for the node immediately above both of them, the one that they share. Then Doug is able to apply that key derivation function, the ratchet, two times to learn the rest of the new keys on the path up to the root. Overall, Carol had to encrypt and send three new keys instead of all five other members of the group. Three and five aren't that different, but if you have hundreds or thousands of people in the group chat, it makes a big difference. The number of keys that have to be encrypted and sent is logarithmic in the number of participants. It's way smaller. And the update has increased the security. If Carol's private key had been compromised, giving someone access to the group chat, they would be kicked out. Let's say that Bob wants to remove Doug. First, Doug is removed from the tree. Bob tells the remaining group members to blank out Doug's leaf node and all the nodes on the path up to the root. These were all the private keys that Doug knew. So, as long as the group agrees to never use them again, Doug cannot access the group chat anymore. But that also removed the root key, the one that we need to encrypt the group messages. To fix this, Bob does an update procedure, the process we just discussed, where he generates a new private key and then uses the key derivation function to ratchet it up the tree, eventually getting a new root key. And that new root key is distributed in the same way, using the intermediary nodes on the tree to make the process more efficient. Remember, this tree doesn't really exist anywhere. It's just a way to organize the information. You could leave all of the intermediate nodes blank, but then you'd basically be in the original star situation. The more blank nodes there are, the less efficient the system is. The tree is there to help structure the end-to-end-to-end-to-end-to-end-to-end encrypted group chat to securely and efficiently add and remove members. The whole MLS setup and the ratchet tree is designed as a baseline. It's a standardized protocol for multiple devices communicating together. But each application can work a little differently and have its own features. In fact, it could actually be used outside of standard group messaging. For example, if groups of autonomous devices need to communicate with each other. The actual cipher suite also has some flexibility. Those are the cryptographic algorithms used to, for example, securely share keys. This variability allows for MLS to be used with post-quantum cryptography, cryptography that is secure against attacks from even a quantum computer. But that is a subject for another video. This video is sponsored by Wire, secure messaging, file sharing, and video conferences, all protected with end-to-end encryption. Go to wire.com, W-I-R-E.com, for more information.